Thank you. cards. Our percussionists are switching around here. I want to introduce the next piece. The next piece is Mason Dorma. It is an opera. It is written for tenor voice. The students and I listen to some music. We listen to this. They liked it, so I bought it. speaking of buying things, before we play this, we've had a really magnificent special year. I really want to thank our boosters and our community for all the support. We had a very large wish list here at Pana, and part of that wish list was new tubas. We didn't have any tuba players when I took the job here. Part of that is because we didn't have a working tuba, I think. I don't know, but we didn't have one that really worked. And with all the generosity and fundraising efforts that have gone on this year, we got our fifth new tuba in 2 days ago. So four of them are being played. I'm getting ready to start another student on the next one. But we're really awesome. And we bought a lot of other stuff that has helped our program and our students as well. I'll quit yakking about that now, and we will play Mason Dorma. The challenge with this piece, as with all slower, pretty pieces, is for one, staying together. And I had a discussion with our students about, you know, slow, pretty stuff and dynamics, especially our softs, you know, piano dynamics. We tend to like to play as soft as we can, and we get real whispery sounding. And I explained to them, I said, we have our band is the size that it is, right? We've got two flute players, we've got three clarinetists, three different parts on the clarinet. Everybody in this band is a soloist. Everybody. So we play out, okay? And they're really doing that. They're sounding great. So this is Mason Dorma.
Thank you.
Mrs. Chase wanted me to do the end of the concert. I didn't prepare. A lot of thank yous. I feel like I have the best administration that I've had in probably 15 years. So much support. Anything we seem to ask for, we are getting right now. They want this to grow. They believe in what we're doing. And they're doing a marvelous job helping us attain our goals here. Custodians, they help us out so much setting these things up. We bug them to death, you know, want more and more and more, and they just keep doing it. Again, I mentioned the boosters. They've done a great job. Parents, I want to thank you for supporting your children and supporting me and Mrs. Chase. The Board of Education, they're showing their support as well. Recently, it has been approved. The high school band and high school choir in the spring of 2024 will be performing in Nashville, Tennessee at the Grand Ole Opry and recording at RCA Studios. Woo!
Spring of 24.
And Mrs. Perry, I don't know if you, yeah, she's up there. Mrs. Perry's been helping out a lot with us. She has been a blast to be around. She's a math teacher, but has chosen as her the PBLs they have in junior high. She has chosen to help with the music department as her PBL, and she's a really good pianist and just a wonderful person, and the students love her. So thank you, Mrs. Perry, for everything. And thank you very much for showing up. It's always great to see a nice crowd like this. We still need your support. Ask your students to stay in band, stay in choir, do both if they can. It's something they can take with them the rest of their life. I have a bad knee now, a bad back, and I can't play ball. I can still play music. I try to play ball sometimes. But we still need your support. Band cleanup is part of the grade. Anybody that wants to help stack chairs and things like that, we're welcome to help. On your way out, if you feel so inclined, we have an old beat-up drum that says donations on it. We're always accepting donations, and we really appreciate everything. So thank you. Our last piece is Exaltation by James Swearengen.